Cities, so is about drainage problems that are there. We work with the Central Water Committee in India to learn them how to better use remote sensing to get a better picture of how much water is available where and how much water is being used where. We work with the Food and Agriculture Organization on implementing new tools so that they can give farmers information about why about their having the same production, one is using more water than the other one, so how can it improve their management practices. We work together with, say, cities and also refugee camps on, say, very fast expansions where you don't have the central sewage system, but you have to deal with local sewage systems, so we're developing new treatment ways how you can collect actually sewage without making a complete new sewage system in there.
Oh,
and then maybe if I'm allowed to, I can give you some, say, general information, if you like. And so there's, so the heart of the institute is a training program where we provide MSCs on those different topics that I just mentioned. But we also provide them as short courses. And we also look at how we can collaborate, for example, with Indonesian institutions to develop curriculum. Day after tomorrow, we'll go to Surabaya to see how we can set up a curriculum to assure, say, the link between the management and vocational training. And what we also see is that we provide what we call tailor-made training.
And training can be done here and also there.
Exactly. And we do that in different ways because what we see is that one of the biggest challenges is implementation.
Right.
So just having a training, that's not always enough. So what we sometimes look at is if we can connect the training with also in the end a product that can be directly used also in policy or in the implementation side. And what we now do more and more is we combine what we call high intensive short training, either in the Netherlands or here, with coaching project. And then total duration is about 2 years, but there are just two short, high intensive courses in there. And then over a year, there is through internet or other ways, there is a follow up to guide the students on how to use the material that has been used in the training period. And for that, we had a proposal of a tailor made training on urban drainage. It's actually meant a little bit to what I said is to learn people who apply to this course on the different ways how you can arrange your sanitation and your drainage and also your sewage system. So should it be centralized one or decentralized one, or should it be one in between, so depending on the situation.
Mm-hmm.
How to recognize the different wastewaters, what sort of treatments are say the best to use, what are the pros and cons of treatment, because often it's about the technical innovations but also about the material that you need to
right.
work with the treatment plant, and of course the investment is also an important part in there. And that is also related to operation and maintenance, so to learn students, okay, but what do you need to set up a good operation and maintenance of the equipment if you have that in there. So this is say a general proposal of two short intensive courses, one in the Netherlands, one in Indonesia. And yeah, this is just a starting point so we can arrange and maybe shift the topics or put more emphasis on certain topics that in your particular case.
Yeah. Thank you. Professor Morris, thank you. Number one, it is indeed one of our biggest challenges with respect to water management.
Mm-hmm.
Supply of water rising sea level.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're also facing water coming from the island.
Yeah.
And then now with the climate change, we're facing heavy rain.
Yes.
Beyond beyond the capacity of our drainage system.
Yeah.
So three fronts simultaneously. On top of that, as you mentioned here, our sewage system
mm-hmm.
is far from complete. It's only
yeah.
covered 10%
yeah.
For now. And that's something we need to deal with. And then we're also dealing with drinking water challenges.
Mm-hmm.
So if we may look at the priority now, of course all is important.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, you have to list the,
yes.
the priority.
Yeah.
Short term is managing flood.
Mm-hmm.
That's first priority. And we need to manage our drainage system because it was designed to handle medium size rain.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're dealing with heavy rain that broke our records.
Yes.
So capacity on that. And number two is with regard to drinking water,
mm-hmm.
Especially for the less privileged.
Yes.
Access to drinking water. And then number three is related to the sewerage
mm-hmm.
system.
Yeah.
As you mentioned here, the coil, coli contaminations,
mm-hmm.
the E. coli contaminations is indeed an issue for us. Now, with that, this is a very interesting proposal. Let's follow it.
Yeah.
And perhaps we can look at flood handling first.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Especially dealing with local rains. How do we deal with existing drainage system?
Yes.
For example, we need to adopt zero runoff
mm-hmm.
policy
yeah.
for every building, and what is the best way to do that,
yes.
and what kind of drainage, vertical drainage system
mm-hmm.
we need to adopt,
yeah.
Where can we refer for best practice on this,
yeah.
things like that. With regard to water coming in from the island, we can deal with that, build more dam there,
mm-hmm.
control the water.
Yeah.
But our concern is more on the local rain.
Yeah.
And in the past 2 months, all floods that we experience mostly caused by local rain.
Yes.
It simply takes time for the water to recede.
Mm-hmm.
And with the existing system, we still have to experience more than 6 hours
yes.
of water residing.
Yeah.
Period,
yeah.
and it is already considered as flood.
Yeah.
If it is less than 6 hours, it's more Ganangandaba.
Inundation.
What?
Inundation. Inundation. Inundation.
Okay.
Indeed.
Yes.
Inundation.
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 Okay. Inundation is Ganangandaba.
Yeah. It's more like flood water.
Yeah. And that's accepted.
Flood.
Yeah,
to deal with
but
that.
Just because of
yeah.
the size of a
yeah. yeah.
So anyway, let's explore the possibility of having.
Yeah, but I think you're completely right. I do see that some of them are combined, because I can imagine that when you're looking at keeping more water in the hills, it could also may help you partly solving drinking water problems. So maybe some.
Okay.
Solutions can also solve other solutions. I think that's quite interesting as well. What we had before is we had an MOU with the central province of the province of Central Java for 5 years. And within this MOU, we had different courses. So we helped them in addressing one topic after the other, like you're proposing as well. And maybe something like that could also be of your interest. To set that up and then decide on which which courses should come first and which one later on. And I think the problems with say, flooding coming from torrential rains is something that you see in a lot of cities happening globally at the moment. There are also a lot of different sorts of solutions. Solutions depend, one, on, of course, the environment conditions of the specific city. Also on, I think, the policies and the implementation of the policies that are possible in the city to really implement at a large scale. And depending also on the amount of water, because a part of the problems, just as one example, in San Francisco, they're looking at installing green roofs. So they want to reduce a part of the peak flow by capturing and holding water on the roofs of the bigger buildings. I think that's possible over there. I think here you have more water than they have. So it will only cover a small part of it, so it will not be enough. I'll show you. We'll have to think also about other ways of doing that. They're also looking at some other places where you can install, let's say, capturing under the streets or under the pavements. That will require a lot of restructuring. Depends also a little bit on the depth of the groundwater system. You have high groundwater system, so you have to look if that is a storage option that can be installed as well. What you often see is that those bigger investments are only possible in a longer period of time. So for example, if you have to resurface a road and you have to put money in there, and then it becomes financially possible to also implement the other structures. Otherwise, it's sometimes just for financial reasons quite difficult. So those are typical issues that, that we would like to address, and that may help people to be well aware about those measures.
Sure. We may need also to, unfortunately, the person in charge of water management development is unavailable this morning. I think it's also interesting to hear the more detailed challenges that we have.
Yes.
And then you can sort of review and take a look which kind of courses on your menu that may be relevant, and also best practices that has been done in other places, so that it can be, you know, when we're talking about this tailored program, it's more relevant to our immediate need. How long will you be in Jakarta?
I'm leaving tomorrow evening.
You're looking back to the Netherlands?
I'm going back to the Netherlands. But I think I have two Indonesian colleagues. One of them is coming from the same university as you visited. So she also told me to give her best regards to you. So she's Mita Kuruma.
Oh, Mita.
Yes. And I think that I understand you're alumni of Mahi.
Yeah, we are from the same university.
I'm also from Mahi.
University, but for my master. I also study water management there. I know that you are the head of research department there. Out there.
So there are a lot of, I think, also informal connections that also help.
Because if possible, let's design this and have a second quarter event, and in our second quarter, just before we offer all our flood management program, because we will be investing a lot this year for our water management, but to do that, let's also see some best practices.
I think that would be quite interesting, and I think just as one other thing that could be done, so that's why I think it's quite interesting to indeed have a follow-up and talk a little bit more about details. If at one point you require, for example, a sewage management system as well, a part of the training could also be focused on introducing the tool to do the management part. So the training could be that you explain about all the possibilities, but it could also be very much focused on the tool that you choose to use to help us in implementing the tool and using it. So that could also be a possibility that we could have an impact.
Some of the things that we need to do is to expose our team with step of the art approach on managing our flood. For many of our team members, especially those who work on the field, they have been dealing with this issue for years and years, mm-hmm. and they get used to this. And unfortunately, minimum opportunity for international learning and exposure to best practices mm-hmm. on handling this issue. And this is the kind of hopefully eye-opening session on how things have evolved across the globe, so that we can catch up. I mean, if you're learning water management out there, then it should be more of our team mm-hmm. that is able to yeah. have that, yeah. especially those who work on the field.
Yeah, I think that's for us, I think it's always important that our students, they learn to look from different perspectives towards the same problem. Yeah. So that maybe not necessarily the prime solution comes on the board there, but it triggers ideas. Mm-hmm. And I think sometimes that generates new innovations that can be applied locally. And I think that's one of the main aims of such an exercise. Yes. Yeah, I mean, that's also for you to decide. This was just one initial idea, and we can arrange that in different ways. Yes.
Yeah. Why did we do this? Number one, thank you for the opportunity. We are interested. Number two, we'd like to explore further mm-hmm. more on the designing yeah. of the program to truly suit our short-term needs. Mm-hmm. And then number three is the kind of cooperation that yeah. needs to be explored. And four is the time frame
yes.
of yeah. how this can be done.
Yeah. Because if I understood the time frame correctly, then for you it will be quite important not to wait too long, actually, because you're going to have all those lessons coming.
Second quarter.
Yeah.
Month.
Yeah.
Well, this is a trip of a week.
Yeah.
A week trip in the Netherlands and a week in Jakarta.
Yeah.
Anggaran juga ada. Jadi you can send.
Yeah. Okay.
The last point, not last but fifth, not last. We put also notes. Hopefully, the coronavirus is handled well, so that travel abroad.
Yeah.
These things are quite good.
Yeah. Especially, it's a big problem there. So I agree. I mean, I think that's something that we have to take care of quite aggressively.
Yeah, we have been canceling so many events.
Yeah.
And even yesterday during the welcoming of the His Majesty, the protocols were somewhat changed.
Okay.
To greet His Majesty.
Yeah.
There's only one person that greet.
Yeah.
Otherwise it's no longer, I mean, we don't do handshaking and all of that.
Yeah, that's, I have to get used to that, so we use namaste.
Yeah. Even though you don't open your mask, it's fine, but.
Yeah, No, but that's, that for sure.
So that's one note.
Yeah.
But we do hope get exposed and then many of things that we learn can be practiced. Okay.
Very good. Yeah.
Let's arrange.
The context. What is best way? So you?
Yeah.
So would he?
Professor Morris, how many times have you been reading this chapter?
In this I think this is my real first. The first time I came to Jakarta is very long ago. It was in 1964.
Wow. Not yet more.
I went to school in Kuala Lumpur, Singapore, actually. So I lived for some time over there. And then we were still traveling by boat instead of airplane. So by boat, I came to Jakarta.
1964. You were in high school?
No, that was primary school. I'm not that old yet. I'm old, not that old.
Ah, okay, good. Thank you. Can I also give you my card?
I think, Prof. Morris, if time permits, explore the possibility of meeting him before your departure. So the purpose is you can officially introduced to your team,
mm-hmm.
and then monitor conversation between the and we're happy to come to wherever you are, and then meet your team.
Yeah. Excellent. Yeah.
So
would be quite nice.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Let's have a picture together.
Yes. Can I ask also for a picture on my phone?
Yes. And how you can be your
very much.
Yeah, appreciate.
I'm looking forward to that. So I think you have a big challenge, and we're quite happy to see how we can help by exchanging knowledge. And
sure.
And see if we can benefit from
that. Okay,
thank you very much.
Yes.